Hi, everybody, and welcome to Houston Life on this Friday, October 26th. I'm Derek Shore. Courtney is out today. You can't see it now. There's an empty chair right next to me. But do not worry, everybody. This empty seat in just a few moments will be filled by someone very, very special. But first, you might want to take notes on today's show. Halloween is only a few days away now, and if you need something for the kids to do to celebrate, we've got you covered, from scavenger hunts to costume parties, how you can experience monster mayhem at the Children's Museum. And as always, there is so much to do in Houston this weekend, including the Puerto Rican, Cuban, and Dominican Festival. We'll have all the info on how you can join in on the fun coming up later on the show. Okay, but first, a little hint about who is coming up to fill this seat on today's show. I think we have a little music track we can play. Little music track. Okay, she's a Grammy-nominated musician known for songs like Black Horse and A Cherry Tree and Suddenly I See. She's on tour right now promoting her brand new album. Please welcome singer-songwriter KT Tunstall to Houston Life.
Hi.
Welcome, gorgeous.
So how are you?
So good to see you too.
Wow, you did a little wardrobe change from the last time
I
saw you.
Of course.
You look so great.
I'm like a different person.
Well, you look fabulous. You know,
thank
every
you.
Time I hear this song, by the way, it makes me want to watch Devil Wears Prada.
Exactly. So many women all over the world catwalking their way to work to that song. Super cool.
Well, speaking of super cool, you are super cool. You're
thank
super nice.
You.
KT brings nice to a whole new level. When your career really exploded, it was a little more than a decade ago,
yeah.
Right? And you already had a following at that point. But was there a time when you woke up and you said, holy cow, everybody knows who I am?
It does happen to me now and then when I have that pinch me moment where I'm looking at maybe watching a TV show and I hear my music playing, or I'm looking out at this crowd, I'm like, everybody knows my stuff. But it's funny because sometimes people know the song, but they don't know who sang it. So I've met people at parties and they'll go, what do you do? And I'm saying, oh, I'm a singer. And they go, would I know you? And I'm saying, yeah, the star of Devil Wears Prada. And they go, oh, you're on my iPod.
How funny.
And it's so weird if you have a song that's that big that everybody knows all over the world, they sometimes don't know who the singer is. It's
yeah.
really strange.
Oh, and it is true. Everybody around the world knows that song.
Yeah.
Now, talk to us a little bit about your tour, because I know tonight you're performing at the Heights Theater.
Yes.
But life on the road is not easy, right?
I think it maybe seems a little more glamorous from the outside. So, but it's the thing that I always have to plug into is I do what I love. And that gives you so much energy and tolerance for anything that goes on. But, you know, living on a bus, there's six of us, and that's pretty good. There can be up 12 people living on the tour bus.
And you all get along.
And there's some bathroom rules on a bus.
Okay.
Which is no paper.
No paper?
And nothing more than paper.
No paper, like no toilet paper?
Like no toilet paper. It has to go in the garbage.
Wait, hold
it's
on.
The whole, I mean, RV, people who do RV trips will know all about it. But so, you know, and sometimes there's no shower in the venue, so I'm very lucky to have a shower on my bus at the moment, which is
But it
amazing.
Still sounds like it is sort of
rock
like camping
and roll.
In some
it's
way.
Rock, it's basically rock and roll camping.
The life of a rock star.
Yeah.
Well, you know, we do have some exclusive behind-the-scenes footage, KT, that you haven't seen this before, of some of your backup singers in rehearsal. So we want to roll
Who's
this clip.
This?
Legend of the Never Beast. These are my nieces.
They are gorgeous and they sound amazing.
Well, and in the car seat, you can't see, but the one-year-old was singing along as well. And that was the first time I hit, because I hadn't seen Tinkerbell at that point.
Yeah.
Is it interesting to you that you have fans that are as young as my nieces,
yeah.
but also, I mean, you span the generations.
It's really funny because, you know, a lot of bands are looking to have a cool crowd and they only want young kind of, you know, between a certain age. I want everyone and anyone to come to gigs, and one of the things I love most about gigs is that often kids will come with their parents. So it's like, and sometimes it's 20-year-olds with their parents. Sometimes it's 7-year-olds with the parents. Sometimes it's there was one guy, a 14-year-old guy who came with his grandma. Because he was into all my tech and my looping, and she just loved the songs. And so I love the fact that it speaks to different generations, and it's actually something that people can come and enjoy together. But it's a riot. We have such a good time. But yeah, get him young.
It sounds like a good time.
Get them singing along.
Even if you can't flush the toilet paper down the tour bus toilet.
Well, now you know. So if you visit your friends on tour, you will know the protocol.
The behind the scenes.
Yes.
Okay, so we want to put up an image of your album cover because this is what you're on tour right now promoting. Yeah. Wow, there's a rock star right there.
Rock and roll.
Super cool. So you have such a wide range in terms of, I mean, we mentioned the Disney movies, we've mentioned, you know, big screen blockbusters. How would you categorize this album if you had to narrow it down?
This is definitely my harder rock record. So what I've done is I've embarked on a trilogy. So this is the second album of three, and the first one was all about the soul and the spirit. This one is about the body, and the next one's going to be about the mind.
You're so deep.
I just needed to challenge myself. I'm much better under pressure, so I needed to give myself a bigger project, and I'm loving it. And I love Star Wars and anything that comes in, you know, longer game stuff I really enjoy. Box sets, all good.
Well, that's so good. Now I know what to get you for your birthday.
But this is the body record. This is all about physical and electric guitar and rocking out.
I have just a quick list of questions.
Yes.
We call this rapid fire, super fast. Quick. Records or CDs?
Records.
Sunrise or sunset?
Sunset.
Favorite boy band? Sorry.
Take That, but you don't know them, they're British.
Oh, I know Take That.
Oh, you do? Okay,
whatever
good.
I said, whatever I didn't mean it. I just want, okay, guitar, piano?
Guitar.
David Bowie or Patti
Bowie.
Smith? London or LA?
Sorry, Patti. London. I'm gonna have to say London.
Even though you live in LA,
we know
you love it. Favorite singer?
It's gonna be David Bowie again.
David, okay, good choice. And also, are you dressing up
maybe
for Halloween?
Maybe Stevie Nicks, though.
Oh,
let's say Stevie Nicks.
You dress up for her as Halloween?
Yes, Halloween. We've got a Halloween show, and we're all going as zombie versions of any of my album covers.
Oh. That's a good one.
I'm going as myself, as a zombie.
Well, listen, you're going to perform a couple times in today's show. What song are you singing for us first?
I'm going to sing the new single for you, which is called The River.
Okay, perfect. I'm going to let you get ready for that over in our performance area. And a quick reminder, you can catch the lovely KT Tunstall performing tonight at the Heights Theater. But right now, she is going to sing The River. KT, take it away.
Play.
Rican, Cuban, and Dominican Festival is the place to experience the traditions and culture of these Caribbean islands right in the heart of Houston. Festival President Javier Ferrer is joining us in studio with more information. Welcome to Houston Life.
Thank you.
And for this celebration, you guys have really like gained steam over the years because this is the 11th year?
That is correct, our 11th year.
And you guys have, what, about 20,000 attendees?
Absolutely.
So it's huge. It starts at noon on Saturday, by the way, in Midtown Park. What can people expect from the event besides some of the images we just saw on the screen? Because it looks like a lot of music and dancing and food.
There is a lot of food. Puerto Rican food, Cuban food, Dominican food. There's a lot of dancing. There's not one dead second on stage from 12 noon to 10 p.m. Music, dance, you name it.
More than 100 musicians, about 80 professional dancers. So they're going to be keeping the party going all day, starting at noon again. Why is it important that Houston has a festival like this?
Well, one of the best things that Houston has is the diversity, right? So we need a... Every country needs a time and place to celebrate their identity.
Yeah.
So this is perfect to continue disseminating our culture to our children. And not only that, but also educate the community as to what we are and where we come from, what we like, and why we're the way we are.
And everybody is invited to this, right?
Everybody can come.
So if you love that sound of Caribbean music, that is okay, even if you're not from Puerto Rico or Cuba.
Absolutely. To make an emphasis on the Caribbean music, salsa, merengue, bachata, reggaeton, cubaton, that's all from the three islands of the Caribbean.
Ah, perfect. Well, a lovely combo of music. We just had the information up there on your screen. Again, it starts on Saturday at noon, Midtown Park. And for more information, you can visit prcfestival.com. And by the way, still to come, we will celebrate the Hispanic Caribbean culture through their food with a Cuban-style pork roast recipe you can do at home. Javier Ferrer, thank you so much for stopping by.
Thank you, Derek. I appreciate it.
But before we get to that, Hijas de Borriquen, they are the first and the only Puerto Rican folkloric ballet in Houston. They will be performing tomorrow at the festival. They are in our studio now with a performance to the sounds of plena music. Take it away, ladies. The Caribbean islands of Cuba, Puerto Rico, and the Dominican Republic share in their cuisine their love of pernil, or pork shoulder roast. Here with a traditional Cuban-style recipe is Chef Christopher Dillon, owner of Sofrito Restaurant in Garden Oaks. And you guys are one of the restaurants that will be participating in the festival.
Yes, we're going to be providing a specific dessert, special dessert that we're going to do during the festival in the VIP area.
Oh, very nice. And for people who haven't been to Sofrito, you guys are on 34th?
We're on Ella, right inside of Dr. Gleam Car Wash.
Very nice. I love a restaurant inside a car wash. So let's talk about this dish, pernil. This is a traditional dish that would be eaten when? Every day of the week or only special occasions?
Pretty much anytime we celebrate anything, Thanksgiving, New Year's, Christmas time. It's just a celebratory dish.
Got it. So where a lot of people would have like turkey on a Thanksgiving, pernil is for a holiday as well. Okay, so the ingredients that we're gonna start with, this looks like stuff that most of us probably have in our cabinets at home.
So we have kosher salt, we have garlic cloves,
okay,
a little olive oil, black pepper, cumin, some apple cider vinegar, a little bit of lemon juice, parsley, green onion, and cilantro.
All right, so very basic ingredients. And then what are we doing with these? These help prepare the meat, yeah?
Yes, pretty much that's the marinade that we're gonna use to set it in the fridge overnight. It's heavily salted, so that salt penetrates the pork and gives it the traditional flavor.
Okay, so why don't I, since I don't have gloves on, I'll deal with the spices and with the herbs here. Tell me what to do.
So first of all, we're gonna start off with the garlic and add that in there.
Oh, that's a lot of garlic.
It's heavy, heavy garlic. And then the salt, it's also a lot of salt.
Okay.
Now you wanna start mashing that in there because the coarseness of the salt and the garlic helps you muddle it.
Oh, okay, got it. So, and fresh garlic, I mean, there's no substitute for it. Some people buy the prepackaged stuff, you know, and it ages in your fridge, it gets a little mushy.
It gets real weak in flavor, so you never want to do that. You might as well just peel the cloves.
So you like the bite of a fresh garlic. Man, this smells good. Okay, Chris, what's next?
Next after that, you want to add a little bit of oil, and that's going to help you pestle it a little bit better.
Okay, I'm going to turn this up just so our viewers at home can see that.
So you're trying to get pretty much kind of like a slurry type consistency in there.
Man, this is a workout.
So then after you're there a little bit more, we're going to go ahead and add the rest of the spices.
Some black pepper.
A little bit of cumin. And then get that, work that really in there.
What if someone doesn't have a mortar and pestle at home?
If you don't have a mortar and pestle, you can just throw it all in a blender, pulse it 2 or 3 times, and you don't have to go through all this work.
Why couldn't you have brought a blender today? No, I'm kidding. I'm enjoying myself. This is fun. Okay, so you could use a blender if needed.
So once that's a little more puree, we're going to add our herbs in there.
Oh, dude, this smells so good. I feel like it's like opening up my pores. This is awesome.
The whole point of the mortar and pestle is to get all the oils out and release them in our mix.
And that's why, I mean, you see a lot of people with herbs. Like a bartender will always like smack the herb to get the oil to come out. Don't you love that my point of reference is at the bar? Okay, so I'm continuing to do this. And this looks like a pretty well-mashed consistency, Chris.
Sorry.
It's all good. All right.
So then after you get that, we're going to have a product done like this. This is one that I already did in the blender before we got here.
So that's what this
It should look like this once you put it in the blender. It's like a green, pasty.
So it's almost like a pesto consistency.
Yes.
Okay, great.
So next, when you get the pork, and I've already pre-peeled this one back to make it a little bit easier, we want to go ahead and slid the skin out. Because if you put this directly on the skin, that flavor's not going to penetrate the meat. It's just going to stay on the outside.
Okay.
So we want to go ahead and peel this back as much as possible and leave like a flap so then we can cover it back on top.
Got it. Okay, so you don't want it fully disconnected.
And you just want to pull it back little by little and then just slice across the line.
Okay.
A few times.
And we only have about a minute left. I know, it goes by lightning quick.
So the final things we'll do is we want to go ahead and like inject holes right across.
So you're just going straight down then that pork shoulder.
And don't jam it in there. The last thing you want to do is break the tip of your knife and mess somebody's weekend up.
Okay.
So once we get that, we'll get our mixture.
Okay.
Rub it all across. And we're going to try to really work it in there.
So you're going to massage that in.
On the bottom meat and on top of the skin. Once that's done, we'll get the garlic cloves and we're going to put about 10 of them through the different holes.
Through those holes that you just made?
Yes.
Okay, got it. So the garlic goes into those pre-cut holes, folding over the
fold
skin.
Fold it, rub it through again. We go ahead and pass it to a metal pan. You want to wrap it in foil. And you want to make sure that the foil doesn't cover the top because the foil will stick to the skin if it's touching directly.
Got it. Okay.
And then pop it in the oven.
Okay. So while you're popping it into our oven over there, that's okay. We can TV time. Things move by lightning quick, Chef Christopher. So this is the finished product here. And when you've served it, what is around the edges here? What are you
serving?
So
right here, these are traditional Caribbean dishes. Like right here, we have arroz congri, which is a Cuban rice and beans. It's black beans and rice with peppers. We have yuca that we serve across all three of the islands. tostones, which is a fried mashed plantain that refried again. And then we have some amarillos, which are the sweeter plantains that we crisp up on a pan.
Plantains, can't pass that up. Chris, thank you so much for stopping by. Thanks for the lightning round cooking lesson. That smells delicious. And folks, if you would like more information on Chef Christopher, visit the Scene on Houston Life section on our website. Thanks again.
Thank you very much.
Looks delicious. Still to come on Houston Life, the Houston SPCA helps tens of thousands of animals every year, all thanks to your help. We'll go behind the scenes of their brand new home coming up.
It was 1924 when the Houston SPCA began their mission to help local animals in need. Back then, they were based in a small house near the Ship Channel. Now, nearly 100 years later, things are very different. They've just completed a multi-year, multi-million dollar expansion that will allow them to have an even greater impact on the community. Today, I'm seeing the finished product for the first time. My first stop, the Adoption Center. Julie from the Houston SPCA showed me around.
Hi, puppies.
Here, dogs and cats have plenty of room to stretch out and play, and even space where they can get acquainted with potential new owners. Outside, there's plenty of space to run around.
So not one dog park, but two dog parks.
Of course, we've got large dogs on your right, small dogs on your left. We've got to keep it real.
They're gonna have so much room to run around and play.
Oh, it's gonna be so fun.
So I could bring Tex and he could hang out there?
Oh, I can't wait.
But of course, dogs and cats aren't the only animals here. The Houston SPCA also helps rehabilitate livestock, wild animals, and even birds.
So this is our outdoor flight complex. It's going to allow us to rehabilitate wild animals, including rehabilitating bald eagles, and at their own pace, learn to fly again as they heal.
Next to the flight complex for birds, a haven for farm animals.
This is your equine center where you keep the horses.
This is a safe haven for our horses and our farm animals. 25 stalls. A lot of our horses and our farm animals come in, as you know, through our animal cruelty or their owner surrender.
Coming from the animal cruelty cases too, I know a lot of these animals come from heartbreaking situations. So you want to make sure that when they arrive here at the Houston SPCA, they have a comfortable place to call home.
This horse, Mr. Sprinkles, was gentle as could be.
Yeah, can I say hi?
Of course.
Hi, Mr. Sprinkles.
He's healthy and calm, but just a few months ago, things were very different. He was severely malnourished and underweight. But now, months after being rescued by the Houston SPCA, he's healthy and happy, and ready to be adopted into a loving home.
All of our animals that are up for adoption can be found on our website or on a Facebook page.
Oh, I'm in love. He's so good.
I'll get you an application, Derek.
He's so
no
good.
Worries.
Maybe Tex needs a big brother.
We'll be glad to hook you up.
Do you want a little brother? He's a multi-poo.
Next stop, the Wildlife Center. Here, rescued animals are nursed back to health.
Look at those eyes. He seems pretty chill, and he is an educational tool for you here.
Yes, yes. We've actually had this owl for about 10 years. So he's one of our most popular ambassadors, obviously, because he's so adorable.
I think he just winked at me.
I mean,
he likes
me,
right?
Brooke in the Wildlife Center showed me the fancy new homes for the education birds.
It almost looks like this bird is wearing a bit of a toupee.
This is a bird that we actually hatched here at our center in April of 2014.
And this guy seems super chill. Is it because he was raised in captivity, or is that just the nature of this
it
type
was.
Of bird?
It was. You know, we knew pretty early on that we weren't going to be able to release it back into the wild. So he's very used to people being around.
He's a really cool bird. Wow. What's really remarkable about the fact that you guys have this new building is you were able to create these custom habitats for the birds you already have.
Yeah, definitely. This is such an improvement from what we had before.
What kind of difference in these animals' lives do you think it makes for them to have their own habitats made for them?
I think it's much better. It's much more natural. I think they feel much more at home.
Happy, healthy, and home.
Bye, buddy. Yeah, he looks happy.
For nearly 100 years, the Houston SPCA has been protecting all kinds of animals. And now they have a new facility that works as hard as they do.
It's a privilege and an honor to be able to serve these animals in such a beautiful place.
Yeah. I always fall in love and want to take each animal home. Also, we do want to thank Sea Baron Photography for providing some of the footage for that story. And coming up later on in the show, we will meet our pet of the week and share how this sweet little dog named Theo found his forever home thanks to the Houston SPCA. We'll be right back. Friday Football Frenzy is coming up tonight on Channel 2, and our sponsor, Freddy's Frozen Custard and Steak Burgers, is serving up their pumpkin pie concrete right now, but it's only for a short time. And Courtney, who really loves her pumpkin, she got to try it out.
Okay, guys, we are getting a behind-the-scenes look here at Freddy's, and we are basically at what I'm going to call the dessert bar. Hello, custard. That's what this is all about. Such good stuff. And I hear, you know, it's fall, and they have something called a pumpkin pie concrete. Not sure what it is, but this girl here, Catherine, she's the master. What is in this?
It's a delicious pumpkin pie concrete. It comes with vanilla custard, a slice of pie. We blend it together. Garnish it with whipped cream and a splash of cinnamon.
Okay, girl, we gotta make one. Yes, let's do it. What do we get first, custard?
So we're gonna put a scoop of custard in it.
Oh my gosh, look at that.
You wanna help me?
Yeah.
You can put a slice of pie right here.
Okay.
The pie's right there.
Great. And this is the pumpkin pie. Just put it right in there?
Yeah, go ahead.
Okay.
And then we're gonna put another scoop and a half of custard.
Oh, this looks divine. So good.
And then I'm going to come over here and I'm going to blend it for just a couple seconds.
Okay.
Excuse me.
Oh, gotta have whipped cream.
Of course. And then we're going to come over here and just splash it with cinnamon.
Some cinnamon on the top.
There you go.
Oh my gosh. Okay, need a spoon. Gotta test
it. Right over here.
Okay, here we go. Catherine, you are the master.
Mmm. Delicious, mm-hmm. Right?
Mm-hmm. Mmm. Good job, girl.
Thank you.
This is mine, right?
Yeah.
Okay, cool.
Oh my gosh, that looks so delicious. Don't forget to catch the play of the game on tonight's Friday Football Frenzy, sponsored by Freddy's, and check out freddysusa.com if you would like more info. And the Friday Football Frenzy Clutch Player of the Week, brought to you by UT Physicians, is Santa Fe quarterback Nathan Kruger. At last week's game against Crosby, Kruger completed 19 of 33 passes for 175 yards and 3 touchdowns, leading Santa Fe to a 27-20 win against Crosby. Nathan Kruger, congrats on being our Friday Football Frenzy Clutch Player of the Week. Now, Verizon is a proud supporter of high school football and is encouraging students in the Houston area to show their school spirit through its Best Spirit Award competition. And as of this morning, Verizon has provided $12,000 in cash prizes to Houston's Best Spirit Award winners. Stephanie Gonzalez is at this week's winning school. Steph?
That's right, Derek. We are at North Shore High School right now. They are today's Verizon Spirit Award winners. They have a lot of school spirit, so that's why Verizon is here today. I'm now joined by General Manager Jessica Pena. Jessica, this is so cool. Awesome. You guys are, you've been to about, I think, five schools so far?
Going on eight schools.
So 8 schools total. So tell us, what are we doing here today?
So today we will be giving the Best Spirit Award, which is a $2,000 check from Verizon, as well as a plaque for Best Spirit Award and some free swag for the students.
So far, Verizon has donated about $12,000 in cash.
Correct.
To local schools. So you can say that Verizon is pretty involved in the community.
Definitely. Verizon has Houston's back. Between our innovative learning school programs, as well as our commitment to deploy 5G to Houston, we're in it.
Okay, and right now you may see that the gym is a little empty, but it's because the pep rally is about to get started. So guys, make sure to tune in to our Facebook page to see the check presentation live. So make sure to go to Facebook, Houston Live, and just watch these guys receive the $2,000 check. All right, guys, Houston Live will be right back.
Big brown dogs are a dime a dozen in the world of pet adoption. For people walking up and down the aisles of adoptable pups, it can be hard to decide which one to take home. Well, for Theo, it took a full 2 weeks at the Houston SPCA for anyone to notice him in the crowd. But when they did, it wasn't long before a friendship was forged. Boston had lost her beloved dog several months earlier and finally decided she was ready to fill that hole in her heart. That's when she found Theo and knew it was a match made to last. Theo has already made several visits to the dog park and has play dates with his new friend, Buster Jones. Well, that sounds fun. And according to Boston, Theo is already their BFF, the sweetest ever. And from the looks of it, these two will have a rich and wonderful life together. Such cuties. We are joined now by Lisa Tynan from the Houston SPCA, along with Little River, who's been climbing over our stage manager, Katie, here.
You hold this kitten, she will perch on your, she's like a parrot.
You can put her on your shoulder.
All right, well, we'll let her hang out up there while I talk. She may just leap off onto the couch behind me. But this kitten is so social and sweet. I'm gonna try and talk with her tail.
She's awesome.
She's so fearless and brave. She's only 9 weeks old. This is a little baby kitten, but she spent a lot of time in a foster home and has been really well socialized. So this is just her personality.
And if anyone is considering adopting a pet, look at this photo, by the way. Supermodel, hello.
Yes, right.
All of the animals that are up for adoption at the Houston SPCA, they are ready to go. I've been with a lot of the kittens there, seeing as they've, you know, gotten their wellness checks. So if you're adopting from there, you don't have to worry.
Are you leaving? Yes, she is already spayed. She's microchipped, she's vaccinated up to what her age will allow. And she's, this video is of her and her siblings. So there's a litter of them.
I mean,
can you even?
This actually looks like, I thought it was a live shot of my front porch because Brandon's been feeding the neighborhood cats and they all live on our front porch now.
I'm so happy
it's
for you.
It's very cute. We're very happy as well. And by the way, congrats on your brand new home. We saw the
story
earlier.
Yes, it is amazing.
So you guys will be able to touch even more animals.
We're doubling our capacity to be able to save lives like these little ones here. And we have space for more than 150 cats at once. So when we get litters of kittens like this, we can house them all and care for them until somebody comes and adopts them.
Well, and you know what? I'm going to come back just so I can stand there and watch the cats in their little homes play, because now some of them, they have these two-level condos, mm-hmm. and they can go to the one next door. It's super cool.
Yes.
We got to talk about iWalk because it's coming up.
I've lost track of time and realized it's in a week.
It's in a week.
Which is amazing.
Next Saturday, not this Saturday, but a week from this Saturday on November 3rd, there's the info on your screen. Come out and hang out with us. Bring your pets and register beforehand at iWalkForAnimals.org. But I'm going to MC the event and we're going to have a good time.
We're all just going to be hanging out. Hopefully the weather is perfect and people have a blast with us so we can find homes for animals and fundraise for all the ones that we're caring for.
Lisa Tynan, thank you so much. And Little River, come live with us at my house, please, or add to our cat collection. If you'd like to learn more about pet adoptions, just log on to their website, HoustonSPCA.org. All right, folks, are you looking for a safe and family-friendly way to celebrate Halloween? Well, how about a scavenger hunt or a costume party? Still ahead, where you can experience monster mayhem that's spooky but not too scary for kids. We'll be right back. Halloween spirit at the Children's Museum of Houston. From trick-or-treating to slimy fun, science geek Mr. O is serving up a real treat today. And as you can see, he's brought all these magical spooky helpers. Science geek, welcome back to the show.
Thank you so much for having us back. This is a tremendous amount of fun. We are really excited about Halloween. It's one of my favorite holidays personally. And of course, slime making is always a lot of fun, no matter what time of year. I mean, my daughters were, number one, very upset I did not pull them out of school and their tests to come join us today.
Aw, man.
I know. I made them go take their tests. I'm such a bad dad. And but they did help me make a whole bunch of preview slime for what we're going to be talking about today.
Oh.
But slime making at home has really become this incredibly popular piece, which is so great as a science geek, because really it's chemistry in action. And it's really kind of a funny conversation that's been going on online, because a lot of people are concerned about using borax in their slime. And so, because you can go buy big boxes of borax and it's this powder stuff, and and you really shouldn't let kids play with the powder stuff. That's concentrated borax.
Okay.
But then they say, okay, so what about using the StayFlow liquid laundry starch. And that's non-borax. Actually, it is borax. There's borax in the liquid laundry starch.
So what should we be using then?
You can use that. Because it's nice, you can use that. You can use borax, but what I recommend is taking about a teaspoon of borax to about a bottle of water, and that dilutes it down enough that's very safe for kids to handle.
Safe.
It's very safe. And even a lot of people now use baking soda and saline solution, but the saline solution actually has boric acid in it that, when combined with the saline solution, when combined with the baking soda, reacts and forms borax.
Oh, okay.
So it's all chemistry in action. All right, so what we're going to do now is we're going to add in mix-ins, because that's one of the best things about slime now. So if you want to add in all your mix-ins except for the Model Magic. So you start adding the mix-ins, just pour some in, and then you can add in the saline.
I'm going to pause you right there. We got to go to NBC for this special report.
Oh, okay.